In this video, you'll see how you can modernize migrated servers with AWS Application Migration Service, or AWS MGN. With this framework, you can easily configure disaster recovery, upgrade and modify your host operating system, and convert subscriptions to AWS-managed subscriptions. We'll begin at the AWS Application Migration Service console. To get started, let's navigate to the Settings page. Here, we'll create a post-launch settings template. To use this template, we must first activate the post-launch actions. This allows MGN to install the AWS Systems Manager agent on newly launched servers and execute the predefined actions. Next, we'll choose a deployment option. Post-launch actions can be executed on test and cutover instances, or cutovers only. The first option is recommended so that the deployment is fully tested before moving into production. Next, we'll select which modernization actions to enable. The Disaster Recovery action installs the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Service, or AWS DRS, agent on each migrated server and configures replication to a specified target region. The Operating System action converts any servers running the open-source CentOS to Rocky Linux. The third action changes a SUSE Linux subscription to an AWS-provided SUSE subscription. Let's build the template. In this case, we'll configure Disaster Recovery. We must also select the region where our recovery instances will be deployed. AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Service must be initialized for your account in the region you selected. We won't enable the other two actions at this time. Let's save the template. Here we can view the post-launch actions we initiated. The template configuration will be available for all new servers added to the console. For source servers already replicating using AWS Application Migration Service, we can revise the post-launch actions directly. Let's open one of our source servers. We'll view its post-launch settings. Only the disaster recovery action is enabled. Let's edit the settings. We'll enable the conversion of CentOS to Rocky Linux. Let's save the settings. The adjustment was saved. Now we'll launch a test instance to execute the post-launch actions for this server. Let's go to the Migration Dashboard tab. We'll launch one test instance. The execution can take some time. Let's review another test instance that we've already launched. Viewing the migration dashboard, we can track the lifecycle of the server and monitor the status of its replication and post-launch actions. Three post-launch actions executed successfully. From here, we can drill down to further review the CentOS to Rocky Linux action. The link brought us to the Systems Manager console, where we can see the command that was run. Let's view the output for the target instance. We can review the result of the conversion. Each action in MGN is a public systems manager document that can be executed on any AWS Elastic Compute Cloud or AWS EC2 instance we have running. Let's close the tab. We can also view details of the disaster recovery initialization by going to the DRS console. The DRS agent has been installed successfully on the instance and is now replicating to the recovery region using DRS. This action was performed automatically, with no manual setup involved in creating the server. You've just seen how you can modernize migrated servers with AWS Application Migration Service. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.